Are you pear-shaped and just super tired of buying the wrong clothes? Are you just wondering where to find pieces that not only fit but make you feel amazing and confident and really reflect your style? Because you're in the right place. In this video, I'm going to teach you not only how to understand choosing with intent, but also you'll learn how to look at certain pieces, understand if they're going to work for you, for your style, and your body, as well as make you feel absolutely amazing. So make sure that you watch all the way through to the end. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button and make sure that you turn the bell on because you want to get those notifications on my latest videos that share tips and tricks for dressing your pear-shaped body to make you feel confident and amazing. Look, as a fellow pear-shaped shorty, I get it. The struggle is so real trying to find pieces out here, from looking at websites and these websites basically catfishing you, to picking the wrong materials, thinking something's just gonna look better than it doesn't, trying to understand how you mix and match your pieces together. I have been through it, and I have been in the blogging space for over 7 years, sharing with my fellow pear shapes how you can pick the right pieces and really maximize your wardrobe to really create a wardrobe that you love and maximize the pieces that you own so you're not wasting money or time. One of the concepts you are probably hearing a lot is proportions. What are proportions? What does that even mean? So proportions is basically the ratio of your measurements. So you have width proportions, which is how you determine what your body shape is. So your bust to waist to hip ratio makes up your width proportions. And then you also have your vertical proportions, which I don't see a lot of advice really being given on, especially for pear-shaped women or any shape actually, in understanding your vertical proportions, so your torso to leg ratio. To give you an example, here's what I look like in a jumpsuit. As you can see, with my arms out, my bust and my waist is much smaller than my hips. So that is what makes me pear-shaped. Even though I do have broader shoulders, it's fairly slender, making me a pear shape. As you look at my body from a vertical perspective, you can see very clearly that I actually have a shorter torso compared to my legs. I have much longer legs than my torso area. And these are all things that you need to understand as you start to pick clothes for your body. So a lot of the advice you have probably been given is basically to make you appear more hourglass shaped. Now, why is that? Just like face symmetry, the hourglass is seen as the most desirable shape only because it is symmetrical. So when you are getting advice, a lot of it is about creating that balance, but most of it is only focusing on creating balance from your width perspective. So adding volume to your shoulder area or to your bust area to even out the width in terms of your bust to your hips so that it looks more balanced. But the other factor that a lot of stylists have not talked about for pear-shaped women is also your vertical proportions and how to balance that out as well. So I just want you to understand those key concepts because that is going to help to create a basis for how you're choosing some of these pieces. The next thing I really want you to understand is your intentions behind choosing your pieces. So now that you know why a lot of stylists push for pairs to try and choose certain pieces to create an hourglass effect, you get to decide if that's what you want to do. You don't have to try and create an hourglass effect with your outfits. That is not mandatory. That is totally a personal decision. Myself, I switch between trying to create an hourglass shape and actually just accentuating my pear shape. Some days I really want to show off my hips and my butt. Like, that's how we're feeling. That's what I want to do. And that is absolutely okay. I don't think that I hear enough stylists say this. It's not that you have to buy these pieces. It's not that you have to avoid certain things. You really just need to understand what is your goal when you're getting dressed and creating this outfit, and then how can you kind of create that balance that you're looking for to get that overall effect. One last important thing before we get into choosing clothes that I want to leave you with: you can really make anything work, okay? In the fashion world, honestly, I firmly believe that if there's something you want to wear, you absolutely can wear it. It just is a matter of whether or not you want to take the time to figure out how to make it work for you. So as you're seeing some of these pieces, again, it's not about what you have to avoid and what you must absolutely buy. I really want you to sit there and consider for yourself, hey, I like that, or you know what, this is something I want to try and I do want to put in this little bit of effort to make it work. And my goal is that you feel empowered to try these things and to figure out how to make them work for you with this basic knowledge of here are things that work for you to make you appear more hourglass shape. Here are things that work for you as you are, as your beautiful pear shape, and as you are highlighting that figure. So let's get into looking at the different pieces and what effects they give so that you can pick pieces that fit and work for you and make you feel amazing. So as you're looking at tops, a lot of the advice that you have probably gotten is you're trying to maximize, you're trying to add volume. Do not feel like you have to. There are five things that you really need to consider as a pear-shaped woman or any woman when it comes to tops. You have necklines, you have sleeve length, You have the volume of the top itself, you have the length of the top, and then any details. What necklines really do for you is they either can draw attention upwards and create more width in terms of your shoulders and attention to your bust, or they can minimize your shoulders. That is really the power of a good neckline, okay? So if you're someone who has broader shoulders and your pear shapes, similar to me, the world is really your oyster when it comes to tops. You really are just kind of avoiding anything that's super fitted around the neck, because if you don't have a long neck, it's just gonna make it look stubby, right? Like, so there's not a lot of concern if you have broader shoulders, but if you are someone who truly has narrower shoulders, a couple of necklines that are really gonna be flattering and are really gonna draw attention upwards and create a little more volume up top for you: off the shoulder tops, cold shoulder tops, you have scoop neck tops, sweetheart necklines, and anything that has a more defined, anything that has a little more definition under the bust area. Those are going to be super, super flattering. Again, they're going to visually draw the eye upwards, and they're going to add a little bit more volume to your shoulders to even out your shape to make it appear more hourglass shape. If that's the goal you're looking for, those are the tops you want to focus on. But if you really are just trying to show off your beautiful pear shape, do not feel like you are restricted to only these necklines. You really can wear just about anything. When it comes to sleeves, it's truly dealer's choice. This is really more about comfort level than anything, right? So if you want fitted sleeves, short sleeves, long sleeves, you really can pull off anything in terms of the length of the sleeves. The one thing that you really need to consider is volume. If you're gonna do a shorter sleeve, it's okay to have some volume up in this area, because again, that will give you the more hourglass effect. But if you have longer sleeves, pay attention to where the volume falls. I've personally worn something with long sleeves that has volume at the bottom of the sleeves, and I didn't think that it added any more weight to the outfit, but I also was very particular about how I chose the piece, so it wouldn't really throw off my proportions. But that being said, if you are not trying to really draw more attention to your hips, if you're wearing long sleeves, just don't do anything that has volume at the bottom of the sleeve. Looking at the length of your tops, you got about four different options, right? You have bralettes, you have cropped, you have a normal length, and then you have oversized. The length of your top not only is going to impact your proportions in terms of your width, but it also will help you in terms of your vertical proportions too. So having a shorter torso, if you're trying to make your torso appear a little bit longer, bralettes are super amazing, and then crop top styles, you want to stop just above the shortest part of your waist. That's gonna be the most flattering. If you're trying to create an hourglass shape, this is also similar advice. You are fine with more fitted tops, you want something structured, but you don't want anything to stop right at your hips. If you're trying to create an hourglass shape, you're either gonna tuck your tops in, or you're gonna want something shorter to really accentuate and create a little more volume up top. And then with oversized, you really don't want anything that stops right at your hips. You really just don't want anything that stops right at your hips if you're not trying to add any volume there. I personally find about mid-thigh is a really good length for oversized shirts. And the great thing about oversized shirts is you can always like turn them into crop tops, so they're very, very versatile. The next thing is the volume of your top. So this is basically just fitted versus structured or oversized. This is about your personal comfort and your personal style here. If you are comfortable with your belly and you're really not trying to hide anything, fitted is perfectly fine. When it comes to fitted tops, just pay attention to the length. You really don't need an oversized or really long fitted top. You really just want it to stop more or less right at your hips, something you can either tuck in or something cropped. If you're somebody who's not as comfortable with your belly or your midsection yet, then I would say that you want some tops that have some volume. So you're thinking ruffles, you're thinking oversized. But again, that's not something that you want really long either. If the goal is to create an hourglass shape, you want to have just more volume or looser tops that stop just above the smallest part of your waist to really create that volume for the top half of your body while you wear something a little more fitted and a little more muted on the bottom to create that hourglass effect. So details can serve two purposes. They can either draw attention or they can distract. So if you're trying to draw attention, think ruffles and patterns and things like that that kind of draw the eye line maybe to your bust if that's what you're going for. If you're trying to distract, think ruching, bunching, all that kind of stuff, especially around the midsection area, because that will help to kind of actually give a minimizing effect if you just are trying to hide a little bit of belly or something like that. In line with tops is jackets and outerwear, and this is really, really simple for your pear shapes. The jackets are going to be same whether you're trying to appear hourglass shape or to show off your pear shape, and it's really crop style or elongated styles. You just do not want anything that stops right at the widest part of your waist. But crop styles are really great for showing off your figure, and they can help to create an illusion of the hourglass shape, especially if we wear a lighter color top compared to a darker color bottom. And the cool thing about longer outerwear is it can actually create a slimming effect. So if you're trying to wear brighter colors without looking too big, You can wear maybe a bright colored dress underneath a darker, longer jacket, which will help to not only elongate, but to slim you out as well. So really, when it comes to jackets, like, the world is your oyster. There's so many amazing styles that you can try and colors and things like that, that there's not a lot off limits. One thing I really want to ask you before we get into the next part is just, what is your favorite go-to outfit that just makes you feel absolutely unstoppable? Please leave it in the comments below. I'm really interested to hear. For me, it's honestly a crop top and a high-waisted bottom. I just feel super unstoppable, super amazing, especially in the summer, just like super boss girl vibes. So let's get into the bottoms. Bottoms can be so frustrating. I absolutely know it. I absolutely understand, because it's like trying to find the right rise in terms of high rise, especially if you're somebody with a shorter torso or even a longer torso, trying to find the right material that's not super fitted, especially if you're trying different styles. So I'm gonna break up the bottoms into four different sections. We're gonna talk about shorts, skirts, pants, and then jeans. So starting with shorts, those are probably the more easier thing, because the only thing, honestly, and this is the only thing I'm really gonna ever tell you to avoid, is low rise short shorts. I don't even care if you're thin. Honestly, for me, low rise short shorts just aren't cute on anybody. So I would say, in terms of shorts, that is the only thing I would say you avoid. But other than that, you have plenty of awesome options. You can go for a mid-rise style, you can go for a high-rise style. Any paper bag effect is gonna look really fun and really flattering. And then in terms of length, it's really just a personal preference. I think that you can wear shorter shorts if that's something you're more comfortable in, have a little cheek poking out for the summer, or if you want a longer style to have a little bit more coverage, somewhere about mid-thigh is really, really flattering as well. Next are skirts, and honestly, I see so much advice about avoiding fitted skirts, and I'm gonna call BS, okay? I have worn fitted skirts, they look amazing. Really, skirts are about comfort level, okay? You could wear a cute fitted skirt with a nice cropped oversized top to balance out your proportions and look absolutely amazing, okay? So when it comes to skirts, it's really a personal preference, and it's really understanding what your intentions are. A lot of the times, I know people are trying to hide a bit of a belly, but I would recommend, if you are trying to wear a more fitted skirt and you're a little bit self-conscious about your belly, look for ruching, look for wrap styles, look for tulip styles. Those are gonna be super flattering. That is really gonna highlight your curves while still hiding that belly and make you look absolutely amazing and flattering. When it comes to pants, there are really three things to consider. You have the rise of the pant, which is how high it comes up on your waist. You have the style of the pant, so what the legs are doing. Are they straight? Are they wide? Are they fit and flare? And then you just have any unique details, like, is there cool buckling? Is there some elastic? So when it comes to rise, the only thing I would say is just err with caution if you ever want to do low-rise jeans. It is not that you cannot do it. The struggle is real, though. Mid-rise and high-rise are going to be your absolute best friends. They're very, very simple to style, and you can just have a lot more versatility and comfort in that and feel a lot more comfortable. Even if you have a flat belly, just low-rise, there's a lot of stress. Is my butt cheeks going to come out? That I would just say you can go ahead and skip that. When it comes to the actual cut of the pants itself, I know that you've probably heard to avoid taper style. BS. I wear taper style fitted pants all the time. It really is about the tops that you choose to pair with them. So I will say that if you're trying to go for an hourglass shape, if you're gonna do anything that's gonna be a tapered or more fitted style, just to get it in darker colors, because that's gonna help to give you a minimizing effect, and then you can easily pair it with a brighter top to even out your proportions. If you really are not concerned about looking hourglass, have at it, because I love me a tapered pair of pants. The other really great pair, anything that's kind of a straight cut will look really, really flattering, and then anything that's more of a wide leg or a flare, I mean, the 70s pants were made for us. I'm gonna say it, like, those look really, really great. So do not hesitate to give those a try. Last style of pant is jeans. I'm not gonna go in depth. I have not one, but two entire videos on jeans for pear-shaped women. Here's the first one, and here is the second one. Go ahead and check those out. I go way into depth talking about brands, the fit, the style, the material, and everything you really need to consider when buying jeans for pear-shaped women. So give those a watch after this video. When it comes to dresses, really the only thing that you want to be hesitant about is anything that doesn't kind of have a bit of shape to it. Not that it's impossible, because you can easily throw a belt, like a wide belt or a low belt, over a non-fitted piece and really give it that structure and look amazing. But just something to think about is, you know, is that you will have to probably do that every time. Anything that just has some shape to it is gonna be your friend. So even A-line dresses, fit flare dresses, wrap dresses, those are all gonna be absolutely amazing. In terms of neckline, if you're trying to have a fuller bust, cowl necks are, like, absolutely flattering. You can see with, like, my slip dresses, cowl necks is my go-to. Higher necklines will also create a little bit more visual volume to the top of your outfit. And then sweetheart necklines, as we talked about with tops, will also add some volume to the top. In terms of length, personal choice. Minis will look absolutely flattering, midi looks absolutely flattering, and maxi will look absolutely flattering. So it's really just what you are more comfortable in and also the occasion. Lastly, we have rompers and jumpsuits. When it comes to jumpsuits and rompers, you're really combining what you learned about the tops with what you learned about shorts and bottoms. And really, if you're going for an hourglass shape, the most important thing is to look for styles that cut in at the smallest part of your waist, that have a little bit more volume on top if it's one color. If they are dual color, you want the lighter color to be on the top and the darker color to be on the bottom. If you're really not worried about creating an hourglass shape and you want something that's gonna highlight your figure, honestly, more form-fitting jumpsuits and rompers are gonna be very, very, very flattering. Pay attention to the necklines. Again, if you have something with sleeves, something that's got a little more plunging style is gonna visually draw the eye here and downwards. Whereas if you have something that's gonna show your shoulders, it's gonna draw the attention more up into your shoulders, making that look a little bit more wider and creating the volume there. And then about the length, again, it's really, do you prefer more fitted? Do you want short? Do you want long? That's a personal preference as well. I'm so glad you stuck with me to the end. This is probably the most important part besides the first two concepts that I shared at the beginning of this video about not only your proportions in terms of your width, but your vertical proportions. So the very last part is how to put pieces together. And this is really a hard concept to explain because it takes a lot of practice and a lot of time. But this is also a really key piece that you need now that you've chosen the pieces to really make this wardrobe work for you. So if you're trying to appear hourglass shape, most of the advice rings true. Brighter colors and patterns go on top, darker colors go on bottom. That creates that balance in terms of your width proportion, so making your bust and your shoulders appear wider to balance out your wider hips. Now, the other thing that you have to take into account, however, is if you do not have balance vertically, your proportions are still going to appear off. So if you have shorter legs, in that case, you might need a nude shoe to add some height. If you have a shorter torso, you might actually want something that's gonna have stripes to really elongate the top and give a little bit more length to your top half versus your bottom half to even out your vertical proportions. So that is why I went in depth at the beginning about your width proportions, but also your vertical proportions, because having that understanding and then understanding what all these different details do for your outfit and for you and for your body all really come together. And the thing is, that isn't to say that you cannot wear colors and patterns and stuff on the bottom, but understanding that depending on your outfit, if you're gonna wear brighter colors, that the darker of the brighter colors should be on bottom to give you that hourglass shape if that's really what you're going for. If you really wanna highlight or accentuate your pear shape, you're really not trying to make it look hourglass shape, you have a lot more flexibility. I say this again and again, like, do not feel that you have to go and make yourself look hourglass shape. You have a lot to play around with if you are just accentuating your figure as is and not really trying to create an illusion of it being anything else. So you can then play with bright colors on the bottom and neutral colors on top, or you can do the darker colors on top and brighter colors on the bottom because you are trying to highlight your hips. So that's where the intention comes together and understanding how different colors and different patterns can all mix and match to really create that figure that you're trying to create and that fit that you're trying to go for. The last thing that I want to leave you with, be picky. This is the number one advice that I can give you that will really make the biggest difference. You are not settling for pieces that will do, will work. No. If you do not feel amazing, if it does not feel absolutely like the softest, most luxurious thing that you have put on your body, set it down. The biggest mistake you can do is buying okay pieces. That is why you do not have a wardrobe that's why you have a wardrobe you don't love, is because you settled on a lot of pieces. Really be patient. Take time to try on pieces and really get a feel for them. Make sure that they are something that you absolutely love, that absolutely work, and go with what you're trying to do and the intentions you have for yourself, your outfit, because that is really gonna exude that confidence. If you have something that's just okay, you're gonna feel just okay. So please, 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 please be picky. Send things back, take things back that really do not work. If there is something that is just okay, resell it. Please be picky. That is honestly the best advice I can give you about choosing the right pieces for you, your wardrobe, and your style that's gonna make you feel absolutely amazing. With that, thank you so, so much for watching all the way into the end. For even more tips and tricks on how to build a wardrobe you love, for how to pair pieces together, that's what I do. So make sure you follow me Here's my social media handle. I share more tips, more tricks, and understanding of how to put outfits together. You can also check out my website, www.littlemissjbstyle.com. There is an email opt-in that you can join to get updates and newsletters on the latest blog posts that share, again, more tips and tricks on choosing the right pieces for you and how to get the most wear out of those pieces and really build that wardrobe that you love and makes you feel confident and absolutely amazing. Be sure that you hit that like button and hit that subscribe button. That lets me know that you vibe with this video and you want to continue to get videos like this. And I will see you next week. Bye.